Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to record your iPhone screen while using your phone. There's an app that you're going to have to download, but it's actually not coming from the App Store. What you're going to do is open up your Safari, so I'm just going to hit my Safari. As you can see, I already have the website open here. It's iemulators.com. I will go ahead and also list the website link down below in the description. So this is the website. You're going to hit the middle section where it says apps, and you're going to scroll down. The application that we want to download is called EveryCord. So I'm just going to hit that. And this screen is going to appear. So at the bottom, you just want to hit download. And another message should come up here shortly. So this is going to come up and you just want to hit install. And then zoom out of your Safari. And as you can see, it's starting to download here. So here's the app. It's called EveryCord. So I'm just going to click it and open it. So as you can see, this untrusted enterprise developer error message comes up right when you try to open the application right off the bat from downloading. So hit cancel. To solve that, you're just going to go into your settings. So I'm going to open up my settings here and in general. So hit general. You're going to scroll down to where it says device management. Hit that. And then the enterprise app here, you're just going to click that one. And you're going to hit the Trust Bunny Safe Inc. And this message will appear. You're just going to hit Trust because you want to allow your iOS system to run this application on this device. So Trust. And then just exit out of your settings here. Zoom out. Go back to the app. Open it up. And this is just asking if they can send you notifications. I say I do not allow. You're going to hit next. Terms and conditions. Majority of the time people don't read it, but I do recommend that you do. At the bottom here, just hit agree. And hit agree again. And then you're going to allow microphone. You want the app to be able to access your microphone for recording. And then allow photos so that it can access your photos or your videos. Hit OK. So this is how it's going to look every time you open up the app. This is the screen you'll see. On the top left corner, you'll see this settings icon. I don't do anything in here. The only thing that I actually would do is just under the video FPS here where it says 30, I open that and I change it to 60. I think it really helps when you're recording to reduce from that lag time. So I'm just going to hit done here. So now that you're here, you're probably wondering, well, where's the start button? How do I start recording? I see my recordings, but there's no way to record, right? So under where it says recording name, you're just going to tap that and a text blinker will come on. And that's where you're going to title your clip that you're going to record right off the bat. So in this case, I'm just going to do test and I'm going to hit done. And a little message here will appear like, are you sure you want to name it test? And I just want to hit yes. As you can see, as soon as you hit yes, it's going to zoom out of the application and it's going to bring you to your phone screen. If you look on the top bar there where it's showing your time, it's highlighted in blue, which is good because that means that now you are in recording mode. Now you can start recording while using your phone. Once you are done recording, you're just going to go back to where your app icon is and you're going to click on it to open it. And on the bottom, you're just going to hit done. And this is just going to ask you, are you sure you want to stop this recording? As soon as you hit yes, it's going to automatically save your recording to your My Recording section in the application. So I'm just going to hit yes here because we're done.
Thanks for watching. And if you thought this video was helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up.